All right, so for this problem here, I've got a triangle that I've shaded in using an interesting pattern here. I want to explain what that pattern is. So we join each of the three sides right in the middle, and I shaded this upside down triangle. And then I repeated that on the bottom. Upside down triangles who have their vertex along the bottom edge. Mm-hmm. And I just kept repeating this over and over, forever and ever and ever.
Infinitely many times,
yeah.
Alright.
Well, you can't tell once the lines go together, but I had a lot of fun making this. Whee! Cool. All right. So, here comes the problem. What portion of the original triangle is shaded? So that's what I need you to answer here. And you can actually draw on this left part of the screen to try to keep track of your work.
Okay.
And I'm allotting you 2 minutes. Of course, anybody watching this video should pause it here and give the problem a try themselves.
Awesome. All right. So what portion of the triangle is shaded? Well, if I look at the big triangle, can I draw on this? Oh, there we go. I look at the big triangle and just that first section, I've got 1/4 that's shaded and 3/4 that, well, 1/4 shaded and 1/4 not shaded. And then the remaining half of the triangle, I've got this repeating pattern here. So I could, this is gonna get kind of tricky. I could try and add up the portions. So let's see, I've got 1/4 shaded plus this little section here. And here, that is 1/4 of the half, so that's 1/8. And then I bet, is this gonna be a like exponential growth in the denominator?
A geometric.
So plus 1/16 plus 1/32, and that will get us down to this next level. But boy, to go beyond that, change of color. 36 seconds left, oh no. All right, I'm gonna say for sure I know that our answer is greater than 1/4, and so here's the answer, and less than 3/4. Did I? Oh no,
yes,
I totally.
You do that backwards.
I can do inequalities. The answer is greater than 1/4 and less than 3/4. That's my solution. It's not much of a solution.
Enter a number. You've only got 10 seconds.
I have to do a guess.
Type a number.
All right. A third.
0.33. Nope. All right, that's time. All right. So, let me explain how to do this problem. So you were right to try to chop it up into more of a geometric type shape, but what I want to draw your attention to is actually the diamond shapes. So you're gonna end up with a bunch of diamond shapes like this.
No way.
Yep, and how much of each of those diamonds is shaded?
A half, so it's a half, because look, you've got a diamond here, and a diamond here, and you can just do the whole entire, like all the way to infinity with that.
The whole triangle is composed of diamonds, half of which are shaded. So then that makes the final answer 1/2. Half of this thing is shaded.
That's really cool.
Yeah. So there were other approaches. The geometric series approach you mentioned would work. But definitely, it's nice to have a slick way. So all of these challenge problems I give you, there's going to be a direct way of attacking it. You're not going to have to use any advanced math.
Just have to think outside the box.
Exactly.
Cool.